According to police, the early morning fire started between 3 and 4 a.m. Police and private firefighters in Jinja spent the greater part of the morning battling the fire that gutted this factory attached to Keshwala Group of Companies.
We are containing this fire, and if we are not here, the extent of damage will be very worse. Because if you look at the affected building in the middle, on the left, we have sodium silicate building. Then on the right, in the middle, we have the affected building. On the right, we have the administrative block of Keshwara Group. So the two buildings, we have prevented fire to spread to the two buildings. The extent will be worse.
According to the Chira Region Police spokesperson James Mubi, property worth millions was destroyed in the night fire due to the highly flammable nature of the material used in the manufacture of candles, polythene bags and car tires. Police used gas to contain the fire from escalating to other units within this factory.
We are preventing it,
Mainly it was a store, it was a factory for candle and the rest. We can't know exactly because for us we are outside this company.
The incident left employees who had turned up in the morning for work dumbfounded as they watched firefighters battle the inferno in the industry.
We are sorry with them because they don't have work now. And we're expecting theft in the village because now people have been working, they don't have jobs now. So we are on high risk. We call upon the government at least to fix them in other companies to start working.
The night shift was safely evacuated from the premises. No injuries or deaths were registered at the scene, according to Mubi. He applauded the Walukuba community and the employees for their support.
We have not registered any injury, we have not registered any death. The community of Walukuba has been supportive. The workers here have been supportive. We have also gotten support from Kachira, Sugar, Nairobi and other companies. So we are at least we have covered the biggest percentage. What we are remaining with is too small.
Anti-riot policemen were seen at the premises trying to prevent chaos as looters allegedly tried to rob from what was left behind. Some were restrained. Police have advised factory proprietors to consider installing water hydrants for such incidents.
The cause of the fire, it will be premature for us to speculate it now, but we shall give that assessment at appropriate time.
At least 5 fire brigades and a truck with carbon dioxide gas from Modern Gas Factory managed to put off the fire, one from Kachira Sugar Limited, Nile Ply Industries, Southern Range Nyanza Industry, and 2 from Jinja Police. Story by Donald Kiria for the news.